All right, y'all, so we have new affiliations for NBA 2K24, and I know a lot of you guys are wondering which affiliation to choose. Well, NBA 2K24 has made that a lot easier for you guys. We're going back to the old winning formula of each affiliation having their respective strengths. We're gonna help break that down. By the end of this video, you should know which affiliation you're going with. We finna get into all the details. Y'all be sure to drop a like and drop a sub if you can. Here's the breakdown and the rewards that you'll receive for each respective affiliation. If you decide to go with Shakedown's Rise, you could earn rewards that go towards your finishing and playmaking. I wanna go through the list of rewards for Shakedown's Rise. The first one is called a brand new heat check gameplay boost. You will get rewarded for your hot hand from the perimeter after knocking down some outside shots. You could also get some finishing boosts. It says earn a permanent boost to your finishing attributes. You also get an opportunity to get a playmaking boost, earn a permanent boost to your playmaking attributes. And now we'll match that up against the Elite affiliation. LD2K's Elite will offer you guys unique gameplay boosts toward your defense and shooting. The first reward that you guys will get for being an Elite affiliate member is called a brand new two-way tenacity gameplay boost. Man, that was a lot. But anyway, it says make a big play on one end of the floor and earn yourself a boost for the next possession going the other way. The next boost you get is toward your defense. Earn a permanent boost to your defensive attributes, so that's pretty dope. And you also get a permanent boost to your shooting attributes. So this is pretty much the breakdown, y'all. If you're a slashing playmaker type of build, you're gonna be going with Rise to receive those type of boosts that accommodate your gameplay. But if you're a defensive oriented shooting type of player, you're gonna want to choose LD2K's Elite. I know a lot of players out there aren't trying to sacrifice a defensive boost to your attributes and also a shooting boost to your attributes permanently. But who knows, folks are saying that it is a slashing type of year. If I had to choose right now, more than likely, I would say I'm going with Elite. With all this information, there's still a ton of questions that need answering. And folks got to talking. Jono sent out this tweet saying, now here's the real question. Do the attribute boosts received from choosing an affiliation count towards unlocking badges and animations? Definitely a valid question, because if these boosts do count towards badges and animations, this is going to change the way in which we make our builds in the first place. Some folks may want to make builds with lower attributes knowing that they're just going to grind out the additional boosts from their affiliation to get those badges and animations. Another great question from Trenton was, also, are boosts only applied in the park or is it across all modes? Let's say you want to take those permanent attribute boosts into the pro-am or rec, will they still be effective? And Brandon asked this most important question, saying how much of a boost we actually talking about here. Are we talking about a permanent plus one to our attributes, or is it possible it could be even more? If we get any additional information or get any of these questions answered, I'll definitely drop an update video for y'all. Y'all be sure to keep it locked. If you guys are tired of running with randoms and you're looking for players to run with on NBA 2K, come on out and join our Discord. We'd love to have you. The link for Discord will be in the description below. I want to thank you guys so much for tuning in, and y'all be sure to keep it locked right here at All City Live TV, because we got a bunch more NBA 2K24 news, information, and updates coming your way. Drop a like and drop a sub on your way out. I'll catch you guys on the next video or live stream. Easy, y'all.